Welcome to my channel Creative Art. I am Nilima and today we are going to make this beautiful wall mirror decor. As it was one of your major requests, friends, to make a huge wall decor. So this one is for you, friends. This time I have given it an antique look using gold dust, and to make the whole wall decor I have used only one shape of mirror, which gives it an absolute look and also brings up the design very beautifully. This mirror wall decor can go on any wall of your living room and it will really brighten up your space. So friends, do give it a try, make it yourself by watching the whole video, and do subscribe my channel, friends, for more creative art painting videos, and do press the bell icon to get notifications for each video I post every day. All the materials needed to make this antique mirror wall decor are mentioned in the description box below with their links from where you can also buy them online. So let's start this DIY now, friends. Now friends, our first step is that we require a plain white canvas. Nothing is better than a plain white canvas. So this time I have taken a 3 x 2 feet size canvas. That is quite a big size of canvas. Then using a sharp and pointy pencil, start drawing on canvas. But for few special DIYs like this, I already draw my design on this size of big paper so that I may imprint the same exact design without spoiling my canvas. So friends, this is how our design looks when I have made it on canvas. This is quite a huge design, so I'm showing you from the top view of it and from the close-up, and this is how the whole design looks. Now friends, it's time to place mirror on the canvas. So as you can see here, I have 4 to 5 different variety of mirrors. The first is diamond shape mirror, second is triangle shape mirror, third is square, and this is a teardrop shape mirror, which is my favorite. I also have round shape mirrors, but it completely doesn't fit to my design, so I haven't included. But I have noticed one thing, that the smaller size the mirrors are, the better it is going to fit your design. So the smallest size of mirror I have is this diamond shape mirrors, but I have placed it on my design and it doesn't fit exactly how I want. The second one, the triangle shape, also doesn't fit completely. It goes with the shape, but there are big blanks which I don't need in my design. The next one I placed and this fits perfectly. This is the teardrop shape, and my designs are also very curvy, and this teardrop shape have curves, so this is going to fit my design perfectly if they would be small. These are quite big in size. It would be better if they were small, but currently I'm going to use one type of mirror because the design looks better if you use only one shape of mirror. So let's start with this one and hope for the best. Okay, now we are going to start placing mirror. For that, first of all, I'll apply texture paste on our base, and as you can see, I'm just following the lining of the same design we have made. Then do it from this side also. This texture paste is a combination of Arabic gum and marble powder, so it sticks perfectly. Then place the mirror on the paste, and the lining of the texture paste will give a support or a direction to maintain the shape. First of all, you have to start from one edge. Gently press them. First, you have to very carefully place all the mirrors to give only the shape of the design, okay? So in this way, friends, first we have to give the shape, and in the last we have to do the filling. But till that, I'll show you how I'm going to do it. So, in this way, we have to do the filling in between the glasses, and you can see there are a few empty spaces. So till now, let them be, because I'm going to show you a final correction when these glasses will get dry. So in the same way, I'm going to place glasses all over my canvas, because it is a huge canvas, so it will take a lot of time if I shoot everything, but this is the way how you have to place the glass. Let me show you once again, friends. First of all, I'm going to give a shape to the design in this way. So I'll apply the paste, fill up enough quantity of paste needed, and then one by one I'll start placing the mirrors. Press it gently, then place the next one just according to the shape. The shape should not be disturbed in any case. Now again place the paste. You have to keep doing the same in small parts, okay? Then place the mirror. You have to first of all place the mirror in the boundaries so that your boundary is highlighted and it's absolute to the size. Press them each time. Each time keep placing the glass pieces according to the shape. Okay, so after we have placed all the mirrors, we will let this part get dry, and as you can see here, there are a few blanks present, and only then we are going to fill up these blanks. Now friends, the mirror and clay has got dried up completely, so we are going to do the filling using the same paste. First of all, you have to place the paste using cone in the gaps of the mirror in this way. And then using some water in your fingers, just tap on the clay so that it gets settled and smoothened completely, so that the mirror would never poke your hands if you're in case touching the mirrors or going all over the mirrors while cleaning. Just smoothening the surface in this way. First, fill up the paste in the gaps of the mirrors. And then using just a little bit of water in your finger, tap 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 on the same clay so that it may get into all the gaps of the mirrors, and you can then smoothen the mirrors in this way. And then finally, using a cloth, wipe out the mirrors. Okay, then you get a smooth surface which is designed by mirrors. You have to let this part get dry, and when this part get dries, after 24 hours you can again wipe the mirrors off, and then you'll receive this kind of clear mirrors. So in the same way, friends, I'm going to do the filling part all over in this design, and then I will show you how it looks. Okay, so friends, this is how beautiful our mirror wall decor looks when I have placed all the mirrors on place, and we have also done the filling part. You can see how clear and beautiful it looks. So now it's time to give it a background color, and for that I have selected two colors. First is black color. Don't be upset, friends, because we are going to use golden dust with it. So black is going to provide a depth, but golden is going to provide a lusty look to our painting. So let's give it a try. And the reflection in mirrors is going to make this wall decor perfect. So first of all, using black color and paintbrush, I'm going to color the whole base as black. It is very important that the shape is clear of the mirror as well as the clay work we have done. So be very careful while doing the black paint. So now friends, coloring the background as black is finally completed. So now we are going to use gold acrylic color. This is gold 08 from Fevicryl. It is written acrylic color, but it is actually a gold dust, and the instructions are given on the back side that you have to add binder, which is medium 2. This is medium 2 to obtain the desired viscosity. So I'll show you how this gold dust looks. This is the gold dust. Take it just a little amount in your cap in this way. Shake the binder very well before you're using it. And just a little amount of binder. Mix it well using a brush. You can actually see how well this both works. Now I have got this consistency of the gold paint, and this is how I'm going to do it. First of all, I'm going to color it from edges in this way. Give it a thick shape, and then using sponge, just give a tapping on the edges to smooth the shape. Okay, so this is how you have to color it to give it antique look. A little bit of rubbing with the sponge will give it an antique look. So each time you have to repeat the step. So friends, in the same way, I'm going to fill up all the borders with a golden color and then I'll show you the final look, how it looks, okay? Now I'm going to color this part. Okay friends, so in the same way, I'm going to do this golden color all over on the black parts and then I will show you how it looks, okay? So friends, this is how beautiful our antique mirror wall decor looks. The golden and black color has completely changed the view of whole painting. You can see it was a white plain background, but just placing the golden and black, it has become an antique look wall mirror decor. So friends, this step was a really very important. If you're going to place it in a dusty place, my advice would be do give it 2 coatings of Liquitex professional varnish on the canvas part so that this may be permanently beautiful as we made it. Let me show you a close-up view of it. So friends, this is the close-up view of our mirror wall decor. You can clearly see how precisely the mirrors are placed according to the shape. This is how you have to do the whole work on the mirror, as well as the golden touch on the black gives it an antique look. I have placed it in my living room with few fake plants as well as with fresh flower lilies. You can decorate it with tea light candle holders. You can place it in different ways, because as this is an antique look mirror wall decor, it absolutely will go with every decor in your home. So friends, please give it a try, make it yourself, and tell me in the comments below, friends, how did you find my video? And if you did like my video, friends, please do like, share, and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.